Greenheck, building value in air.
Hi, I'm Mark Schultz with the Fume Exhaust Tubular Inline Group at Greenheck. Today we're going to go over our Vektor System Control. I'm going to show you the components you'll receive. We'll give you some basic installation tips and show you some startup screens. First item you're going to get is this control box. This will ship with three quick connect cables inside and a pressure transducer. In a separate package, you'll receive a VFD with some additional cabling. There'll be one VFD per fan, so if it's a two fan system, you get two VFDs. Each will have two cables. An IOM instruction manual will be inside that box as well. The last item you'll get will be a sunshield that'll ship separately. If this VFD is going to be installed outdoors, that sunshield is going to have to be installed over it to protect the display screen. So we're over by the Vektor control box, and we've mounted this for a two fan system right now. So I've got my Vektor system control box, two VFDs. If you had a single system, you'd have one VFD. If you had more, obviously you'd have more VFDs. Inside the control box, there's going to be a quick start guide. That'll give you some handy installation tips, show you some proximities, distance for mounting. We're also going to show you the wiring required by you and the wiring that we provide with these quick connect cables. There's a QR code there. If you want to scan that, that'll take you right to the IOM with all the details, wiring instructions, installation instructions. Inside the box, we have it labeled for the 8-pin quick connect, which is going to be for your damper controls. Then each VFD will have a 5-pin quick connect, again labeled inside the box, and then run out to the VFD. The only thing you're going to be bringing to the control box is power, and that'll be run in here. Now we've removed the transformer cover to show you a multi-tap transformer here. Any one of those voltages can be utilized single phase. So now that we've got power applied to our control box and our VFDs, you're going to get a display screen here showing you your fan status. It's going to show your static pressure of your system, your static pressure set point, and your bypass percent open. Now it's going to say 0% for closed, 100% for open. So the pressure transducer does need to be wired by you. You can pull your power from the control box. You're also going to need to provide a static pressure probe and tubing to this unit. Communication with your building management system is going to be done via BACnet. You're going to tie into the Vektor system control. Any VFD information that you need, you're also going to pull through the Vektor system control. We don't want anything tied into the VFD. Only the quick connect cabling that we've supplied is going to be our communication. The display screen on our VFD is just going to show our amp draw and our hertz. It'll be in auto mode when it's working with the system control. Can be put into hand mode for verification of wiring or to bump the fans. It will put your control into alarm when it's in hand mode or off, so it'll have to go back to auto in order to get that alarm off. If you have a powered bypass and or powered isolation damper, you're going to have that 8-pin quick connect cabling we provide from the control box out to the damper junction box on your fan system. Just to close out here, I want to point out the quick start guide. Again, this gives us all the information we need for wiring installation. For further details, you can scan the QR code. That'll have BMS landing points, detailed information, or you can contact your Greenheck rep or go to greenheck.com.